Okay, so before I answer, we got to look at a couple pictures first. So when a horse is not ridden, okay, then I'll go even further back. Here you see the skeleton of a horse, and you see the rib cage goes narrow. Okay, and keep in mind the shoulder has no collarbone. Underneath the shoulder blade goes this muscle, the spinalis, very, very important muscle to balance the horse. And then right here's the rhomboideus, and on this side you see the, on top of the shoulder, the trapezius saddle. So when we look at the horse from the front, okay, you see the shoulder blade, the upper arm, this rib cage is not, I repeat, it's not attached to the shoulder blades or upper arm with another bone, right? It's attached with muscles and ligaments. And the muscles, here's just one, the serratus. I just drawing it in very simple here, so you get the idea. So the rib cage hangs over the shoulder blade. And when a horse is very, very young, the definition is very, very little. So here's the another picture of a horse that is uneven muscular and even has uneven upper arms. Okay. I will come to a picture in a minute where from the upper arm to the rib cage, there's also muscle support that rib cage, that's a pectoralis. But I just wanted to show when you look from the back how one side is more out and one side has less definition. Here's another horse, kind of what the question asked, what to do when I have a horse with big, big outstanding shoulders and behind is all atrophied. The spinalis, the trapezius, the rhomboideus, all gone. Okay, so when a horse lifts his rib cage, so here I drew in the pectoralis, when the horse gets wider, okay, when it's in ridden, these shoulders go out. Okay, they go out. And there's nothing else on top of the rib cage other than the trapezius. Here's the trapezius from the side. So when that comes out below the trapezius, okay, it's the latissimus that goes underneath the tricep. So here where your saddle sits, that latissimus is a very thin, long muscle. It doesn't bulk up. The only time when the horse's shoulder, size of the shoulder, the angle and the withers is very similar, no definition, if there is no weight on it. And the pectoralis and the serratus do not work. They don't have to work hard. But if they have to work hard because they carry weight, they get bigger. And when they get bigger, it pushes the shoulder out. When that happens, it lifts the rib cage up. Look at here, elbow, sternum, elbow. Elbow, where's the sternum now? Oops, it's there. Okay, so as a rider, I can feel when the horse lifts his rib cage up. If you watch somebody who has a very bad posture, okay, you see round shoulder, narrow shoulder, and he's kind of slouching. And if you see a ballerina or a dancer, you always see her shoulders back, she's very tall, and her shoulders are wider than as if she would slouch. So that will make the back muscle longer. And when the back muscle is longer, that's where your saddle sits on. It doesn't get wider. What gets wider? It's the top muscle, the trapezius, and the shoulder. But this here, underneath the latissimus, this longissimus I just showed you, get narrow. So I give you a good example. If you see a man who doesn't work out at all, his stomach, his chest is one plane. If that man would work out and bench press, right, and does serious bodybuilding, which I call horseback riding is serious bodybuilding. So when a horse carries weight or a human carries weight and you focus on bodybuilding in your chest, that man will get pectoralis muscles. So his chest, his pecs gets more. And where his chest muscle gets, where they stop, there will be a divot. There will be a hole, because then you see the eight little squares. It's abdominal muscles. Okay? So you will see definition. And from his tummy up to his chest, there will be a hole. Like here, when the horse gets longer, gets a stronger stomach, the long muscle gets longer, and the longer muscle gets thinner. Trapezius gets wider because it helps that shoulder to go back. The serratus and the pectoralis, where the rib cage hangs, they get wider. So the arms, the front legs go wider and the shoulder gets wider. And then where the saddle sits, okay, that area behind the shoulder right there, okay, will have a different size behind the shoulder now, just like the man with the bodybuilding. So the definition, it's there. So the question was, what do I do about it? So we know the saddle should sit like you see here behind the shoulder blade. And I remember when I worked in England, that was a huge topic. They wanted to know, how am I going to fit this? Okay, I need to keep the tree narrow enough and stuff in here to get the height of the withers. And 9 out of 10 saddle companies, they do exactly that. But the most important part is you need to have a tree width. What is the width of the shoulder and the angle of the shoulder? So the tree has to mimic the shoulder. And the flocking has to create the lift and the cushioning for the shoulder to slide through the padding underneath the tree. Very, very often the tree is way too narrow in the width and way too wide in the angle. Okay, so if you do that, you're squishing all these three muscles. This is a cross section here. This horse doesn't have the big dip you're talking about, but if the tree is too narrow, you're pinching the muscles who want to get bigger, those three, and you have not support where the saddle should sit. So how is that shoulder ever going to go through there? It's not going to happen. Okay, so it's very, very, very important that the tree is wide in the tree width, and depends how the angle of the shoulder is, it has to have the right tree angle. Don't make the mistake and let your saddle fitter adjust the tree for the wither angle. To this day, I remember I was with a new council in England on the phone, and they actually said, we need to stop it. We have 5 different associations in England. Everybody says something different. Everybody's confused. And part of these 5 companies, they're still teaching to make the tree and the tree width and the tree angle to the size of the narrow withers. Will never work. The shoulders want to move, as you see here in the picture. And they cannot move if the tree is not wide enough in the tree width. We have many, many times talked about it, but unfortunately it's still practice that by just widen the angle, it does nothing and it makes it even worse. So here you see the angle, okay, where the pen is, okay? So this is an angle. You can use a digital device or an old fashioned wither angle. But you can see already, even this digital finder here kind of hides the back. But look at how wide this tree width is. Okay, so that would be easy to fit the horse, what is in question right now.